In this video I will show you how you can make a system sketch in PowerPoint in less than 5 minutes. So a system sketch, what is a system sketch? A system sketch is used to plan and get an overview of what you should make. Then afterwards it works also as a documentation of what you have created. Typically, you need to include such a system sketch in your report or in different types of documents. Here you see some examples of different system sketches. In this example, a car data logging system is presented in this system sketch. We have different applications, we have a database, we write to file, we read data from a OBD data logger unit and put that data into a database, and we have different applications. Here we see an overview of the new Corona mobile application, where we have different services, and we see the how these services are connected. Here we see an overview of a pool game system, where we have a vision system, we have a TV screen, and we have some applications, and the vision system is storing the data in a cloud service. So basically, before you start creating your system, you need to get a basic overview of what you are going to make. You need to see the big picture, and you need to see which parts the system consists of and how they are connected. So you should always start to make a simple system sketch. In this video, I will demonstrate how to use Microsoft PowerPoint to make such a system sketch. Of course, there are many other tools than PowerPoint. Typically, PowerPoint I use to have PowerPoint presentations, but PowerPoint has also quite advanced features for drawing, which we will use in this video. Of course, you have more advanced software like Microsoft Visio, etc. to create, if you want to create more advanced system sketches. But typically, PowerPoint is very simple to use. It's very flexible, and you have different shapes like rectangle, circle, arrows, etc. You have different icons you can use. You can of course include images you find on the internet or other images you have created and find on your hard drive. You can make equations, etc. You can also use the draw tools. If you have a touch screen with a pen, you can easily create your own drawings. So in general, people tend to think making a system sketch is too complicated and time consuming, and they end up with not doing this. So now in this video I will show you how you can use PowerPoint and make a basic system sketch in less than 5 minutes. So now you have no excuse not making a system sketch anymore. So I will show and demonstrate how you can use the shapes, icons, equations, and the draw menu to make a basic system sketch in PowerPoint. So this is the background for the system sketch I'm going to make using PowerPoint. So we are going to make a system that log and monitor data from a data collection module like the USB 6008 from National Instruments, and the system should also log data to a file and a database, and the system should be module based so that you have different modules for data configuration, data logging, and monitoring. So let's see how we can use PowerPoint to make a system sketch for this system. So you just need to start up your PowerPoint. In this video I just used the PowerPoint from the video, so I just right click here, create a new slide, and then I can start with a clean slide like this, and then let's start creating our system sketch. So we can start using the shapes, here you have lots of shapes, rectangle, circles, arrows, etc. So let's use some of those. So we should have a data logging application like this. Of course, we can easily change the color like this. We go back to the shapes. We need a database. Here we find a useful shape for database, and we enter some text inside, just entering using our keyboard. So now we have a database. Of course, we can easily change the color, etc. And we need more applications, so I just take a copy of this one. We need a monitoring application like this. We can change the color. This could be purple like this. We need so I just make a copy, a new application. We need a data management application. We use a different color like this, and now we can start drawing some arrows between the different modules. So the data logging should be log data to the database like this. We can change the shape, of course. We can change the width. We can change color, etc. like this. The monitoring application, the data from the database should be presented on the monitoring application, and we have the data management application that should store some data to the database like this. So now we have a good start for our system sketch. Of course, we can just mark it like this. We need to have a DAC module. So I just copy this one. So here we should have a DAC device like this. Here we should use USB 6008 DAC device. So I just type it here, USB 6008. Here the data logging application should be a desktop application like this, and this monitoring application should be a web application. In the desktop application we should use WinForm application. So this is a WinForm application. This one should be an ASP.NET Core application. The DAC device needs some sensors. So let's go on the internet to find some sensors. So we need a temperature sensor. I just search for temperature sensor. Let's say we use a temp36 or something. I Google it. I find images, and I have some images here. Like this one. So I can just save picture as, save it to my hard drive. So I just save it as temp or something, and then I can just open it from my PowerPoint pictures and find this temperature sensor. I can scale it like this. So now we are almost finished with our system sketch. Let's assume we need to have some calculations. I can make a new box here, calculations, you can change the color to green like this, and then let's assume we need to have some formula here, then we can click insert equations, and then we can type here a basic formula like this. So now we have used different shapes, rectangle, we have used a shape for the database, we are using formulas, we have inserted some drawings. Let's see how we can use some of the icons that is part of PowerPoint. So we need to save the data here to a text file as well. So let's search for some file or something. So we can use also here, you see a nice icon for a database. Now we want to save it to a file as well, so we can use this symbol, insert, like this. We can copy this one to illustrate that we are going to save the data to a text file, like this. So now we have used shapes, we have used icons, we have inserted images from internet, we have used equations, etc. So now we have made a quite good sketch using the built-in features in PowerPoint, and we have just used a few minutes to create such a system sketch. Of course, this icon is very beautiful, you have here thousands of different icons you can use. Let's find a temperature icon like this, which you can use instead of this one, like this, and then we can just enter some text, temperature sensor. Of course we can also change colors for these icons, we can just go to shape outline and select a different color like this. Or shape fill, then you can have this red icon instead. The last thing I want to show you is this draw palette. Here, if you have, of course, you can use your mouse, but it would be even better if you have a touchscreen and a pen. Then you can use this freehand drawing to make arrows, so you can change. This one with this one, like this, or remove this one, you can have different colors, like this. Of course now I'm using my mouse cursor, so the drawing will not be so nice, but if you had a pen and a touchscreen it would be much better. So now we are almost finished with our system sketch. I can just click Ctrl H in order to mark all these drawings. I can go to Arrange and Group. And now we have grouped everything. And then I can right click here and Save as Picture. So I can just save this one on my hard drive. I can call it System Sketch. Like this, and then I can open Word. So let's see, let's assume we are going to create our report for this system. So I just select a blank one and type some text, and then I can insert this system drawing from my hard drive. I just select this system sketch we have just made, and then so that's how easily you can create a system sketch, save it as a file and put it into your Word file. Of course, we can right click here, insert caption, etc. So basically, that's how you create a system sketch using PowerPoint and the built-in features. You can use the shapes, you can include icons, you can have pictures and images found on internet, you can include equations, you can have free drawing using the draw tools in PowerPoint, etc. So basically, PowerPoint has advanced features for making system sketches and other drawings. So that's all. So good luck with your system sketches. Thank you.